Hello, welcome to a new video about TMS WebCore for Visual Studio Code. In this video, I'm going to show you a feature that we are working on. This is not yet available, but in any case, it will be nice for you to see a sneak preview about it. It's about packages and component development. So now with TMS WebCore for Visual Studio Code, you can create your own components and use them visually on the form designer. So the first thing that you have to do is to create a new package. Just switch here to the repository and create a new package. We are going to save that package here. I'm going to create a new folder for it, my package. Okay. I'm going to save it. Okay, this is the package itself. It's the extension is dpk. So now what I can do is to create new units inside that package. I'm going to create a new unit and I'm going to rename that unit to test component. Okay. And on the interface, I'm going to be adding some units I'm going to need for my component, which is classes, web, JS, controls, std controls, etc. Okay, I'm going to be defining a new type, which is going to be tTestComponent. This class is going to inherit from tWebLabel. That is, I'm going to create a new component based on an existing component, which is the label component. Okay. I'm going to be adding a new property. For it, I'm going to store the value of that property in a private field, which is going to be called superprop. Type a string, then I'm going to be publishing this property super prop of type string. It's going to be reading from that field that I was adding before. Read and writing super prop. Okay. So this is the code of my component. I don't need anything else. Okay, I'm going to be saving. And I'm going also to create a new unit. I'm going to be renaming this unit test component right. This unit is going to have the code that is needed for my component to be registered. For that, I'm going to be adding to the interface, the unit design interface. This is the unit that contains the procedure that interacts with the IDE in order to register my component inside. Going to be adding a new procedure called register on the implementation. Register. I'm going to be adding here is a function called register components that adds that component to the tool palette, and the first parameter for it is the name of the page inside the tool palette. I'm going to be using test. And then here I can send or I can pass an array of classes. In this case, it's going to be the test component. Well, I have forgotten to add the unit where my component is located, which is test component. This is why code completion was not working. Okay. The test component. Okay. So that's it. This is my package containing two units. One is for the component itself, and another one is to register that component inside the tool palette. So the way to install this package is quite easy. Here on the project manager, for packages, you have here a new option which is called install. So I'm going to click on it, and this what it's doing is to compile my package and to produce the package file that will be installed into the IDE. Okay, it's done. So now what we are going to do is to test our component. So for that, I'm going to create a new window for Visual Studio Code. Okay, I have one window where is my package code, and this window, because my package has already been installed, I can use it. So I'm going to create a new web application. I'm going to place this application here, my app. To be named project one. So So now my application has been created, and on the tool palette I have a new entry, a new category, which is called test. Okay, and here is my test component. Okay, so if I click on it and I place it on the form designer, I can use it right away. And in the object inspector I have a new property which is called superprop. Okay, this is the property that I was adding. So if I see my unit.pass, the ID is adding the right unit to it automatically, which is located on where my package was located. So I can, for example, perfectly, I can run this application. Okay, so here is my application with the my new component, the component that I have just created, placed properly on the browser page. So as you can see, it's quite easy to get new components installed in the IDE. So we are very excited for this new addition, and we are looking forward to see what you can do with component development. Thank you.